absolutely stunning.
Well, it's about time I left Cameroon. I left Douala this morning and I came to Limbe. From Limbe, I am headed towards Idenu. And this is a spot I really wanted to capture. This is the Gulf of Guinea.
Well, I'm here. There's a lot of palm plantation, but this road literally kisses the ocean here. And what you can and must observe is the plastic that is getting pushed out from the ocean to the shores. Another 20 kilometers up this road is Idenu. And if everything goes well,
I'll be sailing from Idenu in Cameroon to Calabar in Nigeria. This is how I'm looking, all dressed first class, sailing across from Idenu in Cameroon towards Calabar in Nigeria. It's been a fabulous experience. It took almost 4 hours because this is not a place where they get the passport stamped for an immigration out. But somehow, thanks to the Indian High Commission's letter and timely intervention by the people in the diplomatic community, I have been stamped out.
This is how the dorm looks like. and we are all ready to roll. It'll be an interesting sail from here. It's a 3-hour sail from Idunu,
and it should be fun. I'm hoping, fingers crossed.
Well,
the storm's out there, and we've just left Idunu, and our boat's got into a small mechanical issue. So we are in the Gulf of Guinea, all around. Well, just about 5 minutes into the trip, and yeah, we seem to be having some issues. We'll figure it out. Words to express. I'm just holding on to dear life. It's a torture!
No, there's no need to go.
Amidst the setting sun of whatever date this is, it's been a fabulous tipsy-turvy sail from Idunu to Calabar. That's Calabar for you. Nigerian Navy. The last one, when I told him, my name is Deepak, he asked, have you been going around the world? I don't know how we got to know about it, but Nigeria, country number 10/46. Well, I'm just done with all the customs and immigration formalities with the Nigerian port authorities, and I'm now headed towards Oweri. I have a good friend, Ken, whom I just met yesterday, who's been a designated person for me for ensuring that I have a very smooth settlement here in Calabar. And, you know, we've been going around a lot of roundabouts in the port of Calabar. I found them to be very, very impressive. And Ken here suggested that he would like to take me to a very beautiful roundabout. Ken, do you want to tell what's the significance of this place?
Okay, as you can see, this is a Mary Slessor roundabout. Mary Slessor.
Okay, Mary
Slessor roundabout, yeah. It's dedicated to the woman called Mary Slessor. In pre-colonial era, at some point, when women will give birth to her twins, and some customs and traditions demand that they are going to be killed because it is part of the tradition. So she educates people that killing of twins is not a taboo, that is something that they should appreciate. So she stopped the killing of twins in Calabar City.
Lovely.
And make it a known place. So in her honor, they decided to build a roundabout in her name. So this avenue alone is called Mary Slessor, and this roundabout is Mary Slessor roundabout, one of the most popular roundabouts in Calabar.
Lovely, lovely.
That is such a beautiful history, you know, a woman educating the others that bearing twins is not evil, and standing up for it and ensuring that, you know, the twins born thereafter continue to survive.